3, Drake the Simpson, Part 5, Marvel's Library.
Out. got it.
I want to get out of here, Knight. Just keep moving forward. Find a way out. Find a way out.
Finished. everywhere.
Damn ambush. Cover me.
You got it.
We've got to get out of here, Knight.
Just keep moving forward. We'll find a way out.
One woman. Goddamn pistol.
Mate! He's finished!
Oh, fucking God.
They got him.
Alright. Going, fella.
way. There's a ladder. Come on, hurry up.
Wait, sorry.
Cutter, where the hell are we?
It's the North Atwood Station. Come on.
Oh shit, what a shot.
Look out, boys. Boys.
Can you read me? We're coming out the old North Apple station. There's no time to explain. We've got company.
Oh, no!
Chloe, can you read me? We're coming out the old North Apple station. There's no time to explain. We've got company.
help me.
Back up, back up! Come on, come on!
Come on!
Get in!
And the guy says, well, you better tickle mine, too, because now I got to catch the goddamn thing.
Cheers. Mm.
To a job? Well done.
Yeah.
Are you going to join us, darling?
Yeah. Yeah. Well, the map proves it. Drake didn't screw around in the East Indies for 6 months. He sailed straight through and headed to Arabia.
Right.
But here's where it gets interesting. You see this mark? This is John D.'s signature.
Who the hell's John D.?
John D., one of Queen Elizabeth's closest advisors. Everybody knows that.
Yeah, yeah, he was a great mathematician and navigator. Okay, way ahead of his time. He's probably the one who invented that.
Seriously into the occult. I mean, like a really creepy dog.
Yeah, see, he signed all his letters to the Queen with this symbol, meaning he was her eyes.
The original 007, you see, look, 007.
Not really that relevant.
So it was John D. who sent Drake to Arabia.
Yeah, it looks that way. Dean Elizabeth.
And Walsingham.
Great, but what for?
Well, that's the million-dollar question, isn't it? And this is where T.E. Lawrence comes in. See, before Lawrence became Lawrence of Arabia...
Great film.
He was an archaeologist. And even when he was just a kid, he was obsessed with history. Everything to do with knights and the Crusades. And he traveled all over, documenting every Crusader site he could find. It's all in here.
All right, you've lost me completely, kid. What the hell has this got to do with Drake?
I'm getting to that. See, after the war, Lawrence said that if he were ever to go back to Arabia, it would be to search for this place he called the Atlantis of the Sands. Now, the legend crops up over and over again under different names. Ubar, Aram of the Pillars, the City of Brass. But the story is always the same.
Well, city of immeasurable wealth, destroyed by God for its arrogance, swallowed forever in the sands of the Rubalkali Desert.
Right here.
I like the immeasurable wealth part, anyway.
And you think this is what Elizabeth and Dee sent Drake after?
Oh, yeah. And more importantly, it's what Marlowe is after.
So, wait, if Drake was on a mission from the Queen to find this place, why all the secrecy? I mean, it looks like he went to a lot of trouble to hide whatever he found, even from Her Majesty.
I don't know.
Oh, I'm sorry, what was that?
No, hang on a second. Because if you recall, the last time we went halfway around the world searching for a lost city, things got more than a little dicey.
Yeah, but this time we have the upper hand. I mean, look, Drake only had half the clues. Lawrence only had half. We have both. And Marlowe has nothing.
Small problem. The Rubalkali Desert, 600 miles across. The Bedouin go around the damn thing.
And even if we knew where it was, which we don't, we would die trying to find
it. Just hold on. You see these symbols here?
Yeah. Looks like Sabaean script.
Sabaean script. Right. Look, the Crusaders were searching for the same lost city 1,000 years ago. But out of all the sites Lawrence documented, only two are marked with these symbols. One in Syria, the other in France. No, you two are going to Syria. We're heading to France. Look, we track down these clues. We find Lawrence's lost city. I'm sure of it.
Well, and then what? How are we going to get across 600 miles of impassable wasteland?
It's in the middle of the desert. So technically, it'd be about 300 miles. Look, I don't know. We'll figure it out.
We burn that bridge when we get to it, eh?
Exactly. What do you say?
What the hell?
Let's do it.
End of the line, I guess. Don't. Looks like we're going the rest of the way on foot. What?
Leave it to you to find a friggin' jungle in the middle of France.
Well, we're definitely headed in the right direction. Chateau should be this way. Not too far. Come on.
Yeah.
Not too far? With you, I never know if that means a quarter mile or 20. Like that time you got us lost in Peru?
Oh, you really want to bring up Peru?
You are not still holding that over me.
I was...